Every 10 to 20 years, a tech revolution changes, well, basically everything. The personal computer, the web, the cloud, mobile, each wave transforming how we live and work, until at some point, we don't even realize it anymore. It's everywhere. And you shouldn't be threatened by it. You should embrace it. Yet we see a huge gap. While 80% of professionals use GenAI at work, 57% of organizations feel unprepared for AI-driven disruption. The number one blocker? A lack of AI literacy, especially in non-tech roles. Not to mention that this new tech comes with a bag of legal, ethical, and compliance risks, especially as legislation catches up. It's not about replacing human thought, it's about the co-intelligence, the seamless blend of human creativity and AI capability. But let's take a step back. 2 seconds. So I think you've seen the headlines, you've heard the promises, artificial intelligence, AI, GenAI, reinforcement learning, RAG, GPT, the next big thing, the revolution, the future. At this point, this isn't another story about far-off possibilities or sci-fi dreams. This is about what's happening right now in the real world. It's quietly started revolutionizing our day-to-day work. Data analysis that once took days, now completed in minutes. Building autonomous workflows. Marketing copy generated in seconds. Semi-automating HR candidate evaluation. Customer inquiries answered instantly 24/7. Again, this isn't hype, it's reality, and it's already changing the game. In 2017, only about 20% of organizations had adopted AI in at least one business function. By 2024, that number had skyrocketed to 72%. But most of it is still individual tinkering, whereas the real potential is for deploying this at scale. First, you need to jump through a few hoops. Skepticism, activation, experimentation, scaling, and then AI maturity. So the question is, where do you currently stand? The mature, the early adopters, those riding the wave, are seeing impacts of GenAI on their bottom line, some attributing up to 10% of their EBIT to GenAI. And it's not only ChatGPT, it's Perplexity, it's Claude, it's the open source models, it's no-code tools, it's coding co-pilots, it's knowing the risks and opportunities behind this tech, it's knowing which tool to apply and when, it's knowing which use cases to tackle and why, it's knowing the difference between a regression, a decision tree, a neural net, GenAI, and reinforcement learning. None of this is actually so complicated, but it's about developing an intuitive understanding of the space. And the timing's actually perfect. To be totally honest, most of us are not 100% sure with how and when this will evolve. We're testing, we're learning, and like any Wild West phase, this is when champions are made and the most opportunities present themselves if you develop this intuitive understanding. As almost always, the greatest investment you can make is learning and comprehension, an investment that compounds over time. Companies using AI are seeing a 40% boost in operational efficiency and 30% reduction in costs. That's not potential, that's profit. By 2028, AI is going to be as ubiquitous as the internet is today, touching every department from IT to human resources. But here's the twist. In this AI-driven world, human intelligence is more crucial than ever before. The true leaders are those who can structure their own data, who can put human insight on top of the AI intelligence. Humans orchestrating the AIs. The companies getting the best results from AI have clearly defined best practices, including clear AI strategies, a leadership that gets it, curated learning journeys for different roles and different levels, and an overall culture of curiosity and experimentation. So this is your wake-up call, but it's also your opportunity. The tools are here, the technology here, the potential is limitless, and the time to act is now. Now AI is redefining intelligence itself. This isn't just another tech shift. It's the next great leap in human progress. The AI revolution isn't coming, it's here. The future is co-intelligent. And the question is, are you ready to shape it for you, your teams, and your organizations?